We have Maryland head coach John Tillman, who's joined by student athletes Connor Kelly and Curtis Corley. We'll start out with an opening statement from the head coach. We'll then ask questions with the student athletes and follow up with questions with the head coach. Opening statement, Coach Tillman.
Sure. First, I'd like to congratulate Coach Janowski and Duke on a great game. You know, they started off fast, and we certainly did not, and I give them credit. You know, we just had a tough time getting our feet under us early, and they made us pay. But just incredibly proud of our guys. Just kept battling and fighting and fighting like they have all year. So obviously very disappointed to see the journey end. I think that's the hardest thing. There's a bunch of tears, and certainly in the locker room. Just, you know, I think at this time of year, whether you get to Monday or not, you know the journey's going to end, and that's probably the hardest thing just because this group's been so tight all year. So I love our guys. I'm proud of them. You know, obviously, I didn't do a very good job of getting them ready, which will sting for a while, but all things, you know, considered, I just love our team, and I'm sorry we couldn't get to Monday. And again, wish Duke good luck. I thought they played great, and certainly have a great chance on Monday against our terrific young team.
NPS Nonprofit Services has the technology and know-how to achieve your nonprofit goals. We have all the tools that you need for your nonprofit to be successful, including tech support, consulting, development strategies, and business continuity to make sure your data is safe on-prem or in the cloud anywhere all the time. Call NPS at 877-797-8776. We're easy to reach and easy to work with.
Questions for the student athletes? Keep your hands raised up front.
Curtis, just what was the biggest difference when they opened the game on a 6-0 run? What wasn't working defensively for the group?
You know, they're a really great team. They came out, they were a little bit, they had a lot more energy than us in the beginning. You know, it's obviously a sting, but I felt like we came back and fought, and we stuck to our game plan. You know, we got great efforts out of our seniors. It's just, that's all I see like this right now. Other than that, I felt like we put in the resilience, and this team's really a resilient group, and fought back. Yeah, we made it a game, and you know, we just set the game plan that Coach Tillman put in this week, and I really felt like we have some building blocks for next week.
I'm from Connor, Patrick Stevens with Cross Magazine. I mean, you guys did get it back to within one there. I'm sure you guys were feeling pretty good. Did it take a lot out of you to get to that point? And what do you think ultimately didn't get you over the hump today?
I mean, that's the best thing about sports, you know, playing down. We had such a great group all year. You know, we worked our tails off, such a resilient group. And when we were down 6-0, I knew we were never out. I know we were going to go on a run. I trusted every one of those guys, Kerwin's friends of them. Just so many great guys that I love to death, and we'll go to battle with any day of the week. The credit to Duke for the great game.
Follow up a little bit there, Connor. You've obviously had a lot of success throughout your career. You leave Maryland, haven't won a national title, all that. I mean, just where do you kind of see the program at? And what do you see for the future of this bunch?
This is the best program to be a part of for any high school players, middle school players. Sort of Maryland sets the standard for what it is, like all across. Just hardworking, resilient, and just so unselfish. I couldn't think of playing for any other program for under those hills. This program's done a great events, obviously. The past couple of years, people themselves in part of a great group. I can't thank enough for the guys. My individual success, it stems from the team, from the top to bottom, starting with Danny Lawrence and ending on the attack, so I can't thank enough for such a great journey.
Curtis, the challenges that Gutterman provides, you know, what did you kind of see from him today, and what kind of makes him such a tough guy?
Yeah, he's a really, really good Dodger, so, you know, he draws a lot of attention, you know, so, you know, he's a really good guy. You know, we were talking after a little bit every now and then, you know, just, he got me on some goals. You know, I just have to spoke for next year. He's really good at that. I'm going to have to talk to him about your route for ending the championship. Hopefully.
Meyer Consulting Engineers. In the past 5 years, our organization has completed over 1,300 projects in the U.S. and abroad, including many structures at the University of Maryland. For structural engineering and materials testing and inspection, call Meyer Consulting Engineers.
Connor, Duke finished with 11 calls, turnovers today. What is that matchup like trying to go against some other goals? I think JT Giles Harris was in that matchup in that area. Just how athletic are they and how tough does it go against that group? Questions for the student athletes?
Just obviously very young group and performed fairly well this year. What's your message to them? Is obviously your career ends, but some of theirs are just starting.
I mean, it's a long journey, but it's quick. You know, don't take anything for granted. You know, they're such a hardworking group. They're in great hands on the coach still, but like you said, it's a young group.
Okay, thank you, Connor and Curtis. We'll take questions now for Coach Tillman. You guys can head back to lock.
Coach, this is Ramsey, College Cross. First five goals for Duke were scored against your short shrift defense. What was Coach Berhart's plan, you know, stop those midfielders early on and then have that run to get you guys back in?
Yeah, you know, the crazy thing about sports, you know, and I think anybody that's been on a team, you know, you're dealing with 18 to 22-year-olds and, you know, you go through the game plan all week and then, you know, I was a little nervous about the stage. You know, we had done a good job all year. We played in front of some big crowds, but the last year's team had such an alpha male mentality and just a confidence that I never felt like at times the moment was too big, and certainly never mentioned it to those guys, but felt like for some of our guys, you know, they were, you know, especially our short sticks, they were younger this year, and we had a couple other younger guys out there, and I just felt like we looked like, you know, the more inexperienced team early. You know, I thought Coach Bernhard put a great game plan together, and our kids have done such a tremendous job all year. You know, you lose Timmy Muller, you lose Isaiah Davis Allen, you lose McManus. You know, we had lost some key components, and the guys had really done a good job. We just looked like, you know, we didn't communicate very well on, like, who was sliding. Certainly had watched the film on 15, and they have six real good players. And we know we had to slide this year. You know, we have young short sticks, so we had to slide and support them. We had some miscommunication early, and we were late. We actually picked up a little too late, and I think that's part of what hurt us was when we addressed the ball, we picked up so late that they were a lot closer than they should have been. And then if you're sliding late on top of that, you're going to get good looks. You know, and certainly 15. You know, we watched those clips over and over again. I think I watched every game all year. We knew how dynamic they were, and we just couldn't figure out, you know, like the guys would come off, and, you know, somebody was like, yeah, I heard, you know, I was hot, or someone was hot, and then we just didn't go, or I turned my head for a second, and they got there. So, again, that's on me for just not, you know, having them organized and having them comfortable and confident there. So. Again, let's give you credit to Duke too. I mean, you're so athletic and so dynamic that, you know, before you know it, if you're a half second late, they're going to make you pay.
Coach, you've seen a lot of fantastic players come through your shop and others throughout your time. What makes guarding so unique and tough to defend?
He's a great player, skill set's terrific. He's got kind of everything you need. You know, he's got great motor. he can finish, he can feed, you know, he's got a good feel for the game, and he kind of has his instincts. It's almost like he's a play ahead, you know, and because he's so multi-dimensional, he can do so many different things, he can really hurt you. So you can see why he's put the year together he has, and I think, you know, with the other guys that are out there, the coaches do a great job of just getting everybody organized, and then everybody kind of knows their role, and, you know, with their spacing and their movement, like if, you know, if you slide to somebody and they get the ball to him, he can carve you up. It's very much like Jeff Teague. We had talked about maybe trying to follow the Teague plan a little bit, maybe shut him. I just think that, you know, we felt like it would have been much harder because all their movement and motion, and just felt like we were probably gonna, it was gonna cause more problems if we did that.
Tills, two things. One, just, you know, how are you feeling there in like early, mid-third quarter? You guys narrow it down, you feel like you have enough in the tank at that point. Two, you watched enough of them on tape this week. Do they have like, it seems like they have like an extra gear where they just kind of kick it in and have those 5 to 10 minute stretches where they kind of put things away. Do you think that kind of happened as well?
Yeah, they've been a kind of a spurt team all year. You know, they're great in transition. They'll make it pay. You know, I felt like, you know, given everything to be down 3 goals at halftime, like we were really fortunate. And again, we get the first one coming out. I thought the goal that really, you know, like it kind of sticks in the back of your head was the one we had a shot clock off the end line. I think it was 8-7. I might be wrong, but we're down one and there's 6 seconds left in the shot clock. You know, we give them a sliver inside and Gutterding jams it in there and I think Robertson throws it in, and give credit, those two guys just making plays. We just didn't help enough. We kind of felt like we could trust Kirk in that position. And again, you know, you make a little mistake and a great player makes you pay. But even there at 9-7, it's like, okay, you know, we're trading punches here. They responded. But boy, if we'd gotten that one and gotten it down and gotten it tied, felt like we might have been able to ride that. Certainly, it was a hot day, but it was hot for both teams. You know, and, you know, I would love to maybe, you know, down one goal in the fourth quarter. Let's see what happens. But again, give your credit to Duke. I thought their goalie was terrific today. It felt like whenever, you know, we got some looks, you know, he kind of stoned us at times. And I thought Danny was terrific as well. Without Danny Morris, I'm not sure where we would have been today.
Hey, John, all four of Duke's coaches played offense in college. How unusual is that? And just in particular, what is their offense like to prepare for in the face?
They're just, you know, they have so many skilled players. They're big, they're athletic, and they're skilled. They're very unselfish, and they're not very complicated. You know, they don't do a ton of things. You know, they run motion, and candidly, flip it on film, it's not too different than what they did in 2014. The last time we played them, they run a lot of motion. Now, they have some variations, the way they rotate, where they put guys. And I think that, you know, they have a culture there, just kind of an offensive philosophy that they're going to kind of do what they do. They'll recruit for those positions, and then, you know, they're just going to execute at a really, really high level. You know, they don't turn the ball over a lot. They don't take a lot of bad shots. They're all athletic. So if you cheat too much on one guy, they can carve you off. And, you know, if you don't slide, they'll make you pay, which obviously we weren't real organized at times, but they move so much that you constantly have to readjust who your hop guy is or who your slide guy is. And at times we kind of hesitated, and they did a great job. You know, they run some wing stuff. And again, like, you know, they do a good job, at least today, of, you know, you're helping with 15, and then Gutterding's popping behind the ball. And if you help too much off of that guy, you know, Gutterding's, you know, stepping in with a lot of room, and not only can he can that, but he also can carve you up, and the other guys are moving inside. So it takes a lot of discipline. You got to be really good at it, and it certainly weren't quite good enough today.
Coach, can you just summarize the seniors and what they've done and what they've done for the program overall?
Yeah, I couldn't be more proud of this group. You know, I got asked by the Big Ten Network out there, and hopefully I won't get too choked up. You know, the hardest part in the locker room, and I think any coach or anybody that's played a sport, you know, when the season ends, you know, it's the only thing I can compare it to is, you know, you're on a train and you get to your destination and the conductor says you got to get off now. And you spent so much time together, you know, since August with the freshmen in this group. But for some of those guys, you know, for Danny, it took me 5 years. and then obviously the seniors, 4 years. I just love this group, and this group has been really tight. You know, we really kind of rallied around, you know, everybody not really giving us a chance. And I don't fault anybody for that. You know, we lost some amazing players, 3 first-teamers, some strong personalities. So there were a lot of holes to fill, and you know, we just knew we would really have to work hard and improve to go where we want to go. And certainly getting here is a tremendous accomplishment for those guys, 4 Final Fours, for Danny and Timmy, 5 Final Fours. You know, having been a coach, you know, at Division III, and then obviously at Navy for a long time, just knowing you never get here, you don't take it for granted, and you realize how hard it is. But I think for me, it's, you know, it's just knowing that, like, they did things the right way. I'm proud of the people they are. You know, we challenge our guys academically. We're on them about going to class, giving back, community service, things like that. And those guys, they did those things. So as an educator, you're like, all right, we got good kids that are doing things the right way. And you know, and as I mentioned, the locker room, it's almost like having a sand dial. You kind of turn it in August, and then eventually it runs out, and it will. So we really embraced every moment. It'll be a lot of fun with this group. It was a blast being with them. And again, like the two hours today where we maybe didn't play quite as well as we'd like, it's not going to define what this group did. They just did such a tremendous job. They took so much pride in representing our school and our state. So I love them for that. And we have a tight group. These guys won't be very far away. You know, they're always going to be Terps, and they left the program in great hands.
Thank you, Coach Tillman. Congrats on a great season.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.